So there are massive forces in this world and massive questions we need answered. And Thomas Aquinas realized this, and I believe he acted on it. And Thomas Aquinas made massive impacts in the world of theology and philosophy. And I think this was made possible through his unrivaled ability to express himself. And throughout my speech, I'm going to be using some notes to kind of help me, like, guide me through. And Thomas Aquinas is one of the greatest religious thinkers ever. This was thought during the time that he was alive, and also 800 years later, it's still very difficult to shake this title. So, yeah. And he answered very important questions to our existence, such as, is there a God? What is the purpose of our lives? And even if you don't agree with his conclusions, I believe it's very important to study his work. And I'm going to be discussing his early life, some contrasting philosophies he was exposed to in his life, and the creation of his most notable work, the Summa Theologica. So, by looking at Thomas Aquinas' early life, you can see he had a very devoted nature to the truth, and he had an idea of where he wanted to go in his life. And he was born in 1225. And while it may seem very foreign to us today, he entered religious life at about 5 or 6 years old. And he studied 8 years in a monastery type place. And then he went to Naples when he was about 15. And in Naples, it was there that he was exposed to the teachings of Aristotle, which will come up more in main point two. And it was also here that he decided, instead of being a more affluent, rich member of the church, he'd rather be a poverty-stricken Dominican brother. And this caused great tension within his family. His brother even kidnapped him to change his mind. But he stuck true to what he wanted, and he entered the Dominican order. And in the article, Thomas Aquinas, Doctor and Saint, in the Sewanee Review, journalist Addison A. Ewing states, the leaders marked Saint Thomas as one who gave special promise, and it was decided to furnish him superior opportunities of education and advancement. So now that I've discussed his early life, I'll be discussing two contrasting philosophies in his life, which was Christian theology and the philosophy of Aristotle, both of which were prominent during the medieval age. And on the website Galen Context, which is the biography of Thomas Aquinas, it claims Christian theology seemed less necessary as an avenue to truth, which because of Aristotle was now accessible to men by natural reason without revelation. So the idea was you could really figure out big questions on your own through, like, science and reason, and you didn't need God. And there were also fundamental differences between Aristotle's God and Aquinas's. For example, Aristotle's idea of God was very uninvolved, while Aquinas's was very concerned and involved. And in Aristotle's view, the universe represented eternity. But in Aquinas' view, God represented eternity, and the universe was a creation of God. And Aquinas, using amazing analytical skills, was able to combine these two seemingly opposites using a very, like, smart thought process by seeing the two aspects of truth in both of them. Now that I've discussed his, like, amazing ability to, like, reason, I'll discuss his most famous work, which is the Summa Theologica. And I believe, based on my research, that it shows his nuanced thought process and his love of knowledge. And some of the main points within the Summa Theologica are grace builds on nature, not destroys it. And that kind of communicates the fact that, like, bettering yourself with the help of God doesn't destroy your nature, it helps build it up. And this is known as the Thomas Axiom. And in the book Thomas Aquinas, A Very Short Introduction, Fergus Kerr concludes, the roots of the axiom lie in Greek patristic theology communicated through Dionysus and well established in the West before. So that's kind of a background of it. And another famous aspect of the Summa Theologica is the five philosophical proofs for the existence of God. And those are, one, there must be an unmoved mover. Two, there must be an uncaused cause. Three, we must be dependent on something. Four, there must be a moral scale to navigate life. And five, non-intelligent creatures and beings need an intelligent leader to instruct them. And another last aspect of the Summa Theologica was the natural world will never satisfy us, which is more of an emotional appeal. And my visual aid for this whole topic is The Confessions of St. Augustine. It's a religious book, and they're very much related, St. Aquinas and St. Augustine, because they're both religious books, and they both approach religion in their own personal way, and it's interesting to see how it impacts their life each time. St. Augustine's is a little bit more personal, but yeah. So I've discussed St. Aquinas, his amazing impacts to theology, and his amazing ability to reason, and his Summa Theologica work. Even if you don't agree with his conclusions, I believe his work's important to study. Thank you for listening.